Going on, everybody. Playing some Madden today. For some reason, I sent the defense because I really suck at defense. And this, we're doing this just to show the offense off. I like playing offense only anyway, so it's no big deal. But we're gonna get in. We're gonna play some football. Hopefully we can win today because Packers are pretty good. We're pretty dismal right now. We gotta work our way up. I'm the Vikings, so most time I'm always the Vikings in these games. This isn't a good idea to rush, but might be trying.
Now the first carry for Adrian Peterson. Officially no gain on the play, and they're left with a 3rd and 8. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold him to no gain.
And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Third down is a down. Both sides know they absolutely have to win. And the name of the game for the defense is pressure on the quarterback. But pressure on the quarterback with contact, that's how you end up winning it.
And now a low liner. I think he mishit it. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. A special teams mistake there, no doubt. Just 26 yards officially on the punt. And the Packers.
Sim. They're just going to kick my ass. Wow. Okay, that works.
It's Rodgers into a double team and it's intercepted. It's
That's what I'm talking
Chad
about.
Greenway with a pick. And they
that'll
were set
do,
up shot at their own 41-yard line. And they told us repeatedly earlier in the week in our meetings, we need some plays from our defense here on the road early. They got one.
And don't think they were above all week long pointing out to their defense that the other defense is rated higher than them. You gonna let that happen, guys? Is that how we're going to play? And they responded to the challenge.
And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. It's a loss of 4 there, bringing up 2nd down.
Well, on that play, the expression, don't blink, you might miss something, certainly applied. That was fast. Defense diagnosed the play, and it was over in a heartbeat.
Gotta get something going.
Bridgewater now on 2nd down. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. They were looking for Johnson that time, and it'll bring up 3rd down.
Well, I'm going to resist laughing just because his name is Ha-Ha. But Ha-Ha Clinton Dix, excellent coverage there. Man coverage, knocked that one away.
Real name, Hashan. He's from down in your neck of the woods in Orlando.
Yeah, went to Dr. Phillips High School and then matriculated at the University of Alabama and played at a super high level at both places and is doing the exact same thing now in the NFL.
Third and long for Bridgewater. It's caught, Michael Pruitt, and he gets it down to the 48, enough for the first. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. Good use of the pass there to pick up the first down against a defensive look that they had specifically prepared for, they told us, coming into this one.
Certainly seems like they're holding all the right cards now, doesn't it? Because of their preparation. Went back, watched the tape, studied the tendencies, and they feel like they had them down cold, and they were able to use the pass against them.
Give them 16 on the pickup, and it'll give the Vikings a 1st down.
But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route, and what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works a defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing, and they got it done.
A really good pickup of 28 yards.
Anytime there's an open target and there's a reception, the next thing you're looking for, the ability to break a tackle and gain additional yardage. That's what we just saw.
Bridgewater again. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
Well, that was point counterpoint, wasn't it? They decided to throw for it on first and goal. Instead, the defense counters with pressure, and the defense wins, getting a big sack.
Second down, Bridgewater. And the hit jarred it
loose.
Come
on, man.
It's incomplete. God, Michael Pruitt, the big tight end, his intended receiver. And that'll make it third down. And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. An extra defensive back on the field here for third and goal. Left side caught by Diggs. And he will score. Touchdown, Vikings. Stephon. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This one fielded at the 5. Now the Minnesota offense set to take over again. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
To throw, Bridgewater. He's got it complete to Diggs, right side. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time.
That's what I'm talking about,
boys. A nice
pickup
there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. Now it's AP, Adrian Peterson. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. But good luck there as a ball carrier. You get handed that football. Look up. Oh, there's a big D tackle ready to swallow you whole for a loss.
Yeah, you kind of count on your guys to give you at least a little bit of time, a little bit of space to try and maneuver. But not on that one. And when you have a defensive tackle who is that strong, that agile, he's a lot to deal with. Sometimes
really
you're
need a better offensive.
Sometimes you're not able to block him no matter who's trying.
I can't run. I don't have
almost
really
not
time to
the big guy
pass.
Running the corner route, being able to lean and push and get to where he wants.
So how do you stop it?
A lot of times you want to have a linebacker on him, a bigger body guy who can handle him physically. But a lot of times that doesn't work as well, because his quickness often wins the route.
5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5. The ball carrier there, Adrian Peterson, he turned 31 back in March.
But after his return from knee surgery a few years ago, that incredible return, I don't think we look at his number the same way as we do a lot of running backs who turn 30.
Yeah, I agree. And right now, standing 17th all-time in the NFL rushing ranks. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
Two minutes to play in a tightly contested first half. More from Minneapolis after this.
Come on, let's do something here.
A reminder coming up at halftime. Larry Ridley will join us from Orlando with our halftime report. But business to take care of before that. Third down, it's Adrian Peterson.
That works.
Down. And now a timeout coming from the defensive side for the Packers.
Oh, bullshit.
It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. On fourth down, here's the Saints rookie kicker Will Lutz for the field goal try. This from 42 yards out. And Walsh able to convert it as his kick is good. And they take the lead here now at 10-7. So it goes down as an 8-play.
Super send this mother out. Guys, the week's been good. We're gonna been okay so far. Mine has, anyways. It's just been busy with Super Bowl and everything. So, kind of inspired me to want to come home and play some football. See if we can't get a Mr. Dogo here. That'll work for me. Well, that's a long way to go for a field goal.
They come out here in the eye. They go play action here on first down. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. A good pick up there, 26 yards.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense, and reading your keys, you always think about that and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? It sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. Here's Bridgewater. And the grab made by the tight end Pruitt.
Gervie's fucking over.
Well, they have the yards anyway, so they're going to decline the penalty. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve.
Let's go.
On first and 10, Bridgewater. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete.
Bad call. That was ridiculous. What are you doing?
When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
A second down throw for Bridgewater. Wide open receiver complete. A big play there just before halftime. 42 yards.
Coaches really don't care from what position they get this, but run after the catch ability, rack ability, is often the difference between winning and losing and changing field position.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. Now they bring a receiver in motion right. They'll run for it with Peterson. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down.
God.
So let's see what this is about.
Holding offense.
Fucking God.
So there you go, holding by the offense, and that'll push him back.
Changes everything now as you try and figure out what your playbook has for you. Longer yardage situations, tougher to execute and pick up first downs.
They'll throw again. Bridgewater. This will be caught at about the 5. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head
really
toward halftime.
A touchdown. That'd be nice to have. One and a half time. Comebacks.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. They come out here in the eye. Bridgewater again. And he
Fuck.
Fires has one that's intercepted. Christian Jones, the one who picked it. And the return just out across the 15 to the 16-yard line. We take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, let's take control right away.
Yeah,
defense,
we got the lead.
Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down. Let's see if the offense gets done.
Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. And look at the numbers, a repeat performance. It seems right now it doesn't matter how many guys they're going to put on him, he's going to catch the football.
And when you hit that zone, and that's what he's in right now, where everything is working well for him, and I think it's in combination with what the offense coordinator is doing. He's a primary target. He looks at his play sheet, knows he wants to get in the football, and has designed some routes effective for the last 2 weeks. He's really been fun to watch. Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
And the offense behind the chains here, a touch on second and 11.
That play never got off the ground because of the defensive front. They owned the offensive line, which allowed the linebackers to see their openings and run straight to the ball. That's why that play just never had a chance. Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move them all over the place to try and find good matchups, and they had one. They were just unable to complete the pass. Third and 11, five in the secondary now.
Nickel look. Throwing, Bridgewater, and this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. They do get nine, but it leads to fourth down.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping them from a first down.
That stopped him in his tracks. So it's only 3 points. After the made field goal, now Crosby will do the kickoff duties. This fielded at the two. What a spin. And it takes across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Now the Vikings offense gets set to take over here. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that. They weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants to drive down with a kick other than the extra point. That's it.
Give them 27 yards in time. And it'll be first down Vikings.
That was a nice completion on an out route. And those types of plays are the result of arm strength by the quarterback and timing by the receiver.
Bridgewater gives to Peterson on the draw. And down to the 36-yard line here.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
Charles, I know it's hard when live bullets are flying, but you cannot keep your hand up around the face mask area.
It is absolutely inexcusable nowadays. We talk about target areas all the time. You have to aim lower so your hand doesn't get involved in the face mask.
Gonna run the clock here. Try to get it to where we can just kick a field goal and win it. I'd be pleased with that.
The play clock's running down. Following the penalty, it's Peterson. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and 5. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
A lot of times this game is just so hard to keep up. You guys entertained, but at least it's a close score. You know, some games, if I miss a complete blowout, I'll just put up the highlights and stuff. But, like, this game is just so close the whole way through.
In the red zone this time. Play clock winding down. Again, Peterson. And this time not as successful as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. Tackle there by Clay Matthews. And he's back here in the struggle department in this one like he was a week ago. And partner, I think you can pin some of this on that O-line, that room to run, just not there.
You mentioned last week that it felt like the offensive line was getting beaten to the punch by the guys across the ball.
Well, it was pretty evident, I thought.
I mean, they were off the ball fast, penetrating, getting into the offensive backfield, really spilling a lot of runs before they got started. So I thought your observation was spot on then, and you're right there again this week. Same thing is happening, not able to get started because they're not able to control the point of attack.
And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Slants are so tough to cover because everything happens so fast, but sometimes it happens too fast for the guy catching the ball because all of his movements have to be quick off the line of scrimmage, and then all of a sudden the ball's right on top of you. And maybe he got a little bit ahead of himself there.
A lot of times coming in with good pace, and he dropped it. So the drive here ends with a field goal, and that does give them the lead, but this one.
Well, may have just lost this one. There's way too much time left on the clock for them. I hope and pray they have to kick it away. Yes! 42. Yes! All right, all we gotta do now is run the clock. Father-in-law just got home. Dogs will be barking for a little bit. I'm sorry about that.
Time for a break.
2 minute warning.
We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. So the Vikings in possession of the football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over.
I'm honestly surprised we've done this good in the game. I figured that we'd get our ass kicked.
They run again with Peterson. And now a timeout coming from the defensive side for the Packers. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. So the offense needing 4 yards, it's third down. Bridgewater to throw. Got a man in train.
Timeout.
Booyah. And the first down as they get into the ground at the 37. So the defense had a chance to catch their breath, and now they're back out and ready. Fresh set of downs here.
Boy, those dogs just love it barking. Whether you can hear them or not.
A toss play. This is Peterson. And he'll get this up to about the 38-yard line. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside.
Watch tight. Tight end's right. Watch tight. Tight end's right.
They come out here in the eye. They run with Peterson. He's been busy tonight. And very little room to maneuver. He'll get this down to about the 39. He'll pick up only a yard there, and it'll leave him with a third and seven.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Bridgewater, the left side caught by Diggs. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. Here's Jeff Locke now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And they're going to take it all the way down and just take the delay.
Delay of game, offense.
Here's Jeff Locke now, as he'll kick it away for the second time.
Wasn't necessarily a called block. Sometimes the guy just finds his way back there. Doesn't matter. The play happens, and that one turned into 6 points because they handled it so well after the block.
He's got it, and it's now a 21-16 lead. Able to get the pressure, get a paw on it, knock it down, and then go and grab it and take it into the end zone. What a play. This one taken just inside the 10. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. And the Vikings now heading onto the field. Critical condition here, obviously. Got to hope to get something quick right and then maybe take that shot deep.
And once they do take the big shot, you've got to worry on defense. Of course, no one getting behind the defense to make it an easy throw. But nowadays, it's not just the ball being tipped in the air and people in the end zone in a cluster. It's that guy that's short in the end zone who comes up and ends up making the play because he goes unguarded. So there's a lot to think about if you're playing defense in this situation.
We'll see if they can cover all their bases.
Let's go.
He'll look to throw. It's complete to Diggs. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. So the offense has it first and 10. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Back to throw. And that will be incomplete. Four ticks left here on the clock.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Force, force.
One last shot now for Bridgewater. He's going to let it fly. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Sam Shields. And
that
is
that sucks. Anyways, well, guys, I'm glad you guys decided to come and watch. It was a fun game. It really was. A lot closer than I thought. I didn't think we had a chance anyways. I don't know why I wasn't paying attention with that punt. I should have just tried to get a first down. I don't know. That's on me. But, you know, what can you do? You're going to win some. You're going to lose some. Wish we could have won it. You know, didn't want to start the series off with a loss. But I thank y'all for your support. Really sucks. But if y'all like the content, you know, hit the like button, subscribe, and we'll talk to you later.